Welcome to this tutorial about the power supply functions of the 8960-20. This video will present three new functions not available when using the 8960 on its own without LVDAC EMS. For the other power supply functions, please refer to the video Basic Power Supply Function for a complete review. Let's begin with the first one, DC Voltage Source. To access this function, connect your 8960 to your computer, turn on the 8960, and start LVDAC EMS. On the main window, locate this icon and click on it. This will open a new window named 4 Quadrant Dynamometer Power Supply. To access a function, go here under Function Selection and select the one you need from the list. Please note that the list is divided into two categories, Power Supply and Dynamometer. To access one of those categories, you have to manually turn the operating mode switch of the 8960 to the desired position. You will see the operating mode change in the bottom left corner of the window, and you will have access to a new function selection. From there, select DC Voltage Source. This function is very simple but quite useful for a large variety of experiments. You can see here a simple schematic that explains what the function is about. In the right section, under Function Selection, you get all the customizable features of this function. Voltage control. To control the function, you can use the knob here or the command input on the front panel of the 8960 using a minus 10 to 10 volt source. Voltage. Set the output voltage of the function. This function can go from minus 147 volts to 147 volts. Thermistor type. Choose your thermistor type in the function you want to protect. Type 1 is for NIMH batteries, and type 2 is for the wind turbine. Status indicates if the function is started or not. Here are all the meters that you can find on the display of the 8960 to inform you of the voltage, current, and power actually produced by the 8960. There is also a meter for the overall energy spent over time in function of the power produced. And finally, a temperature meter. Each of these meters can be turned on or off by clicking here, and can be changed to a needle meter by clicking here in the green rectangle. And finally, here is the start-stop button to control the function. Don't forget to click on the single or continuous refresh button here to see the values in those meters. To use a function, simply select the voltage of your choice and start the function. Now let's try another function, the DC current source. Built exactly on the same basis as the DC voltage source, this function can go from minus 5 amps to 5 amps using the knob here or the command input on the front panel. It works exactly like the DC voltage source, so we suggest you try using it following the same steps as previously seen. Let's get back to the function selection list to get our third function, the AC power source. As you can see in the schematic, this function is an AC source adjustable both in frequency and amplitude. In fact, the function settings are voltage control. For this function, only the knob can be used to control the voltage. Voltage sets the output voltage of the function. This function can go from 0 to 106 volts RMS, which equals a peak voltage of 150 volts. DC offset correction applies a DC voltage to correct any DC offset that can be created by the load applied. Frequency. This setting controls the frequency of the output voltage. It is ranged from 10 Hz to 100 Hz. Thermistor type. Again, choose the thermistor type in the function you want to protect. And finally, status indicates if the function is started or not. The meters, buttons, and knobs work exactly the same as the previous functions, so you'll have no problem using them. Just start the function with this button and control the output voltage with the knob. That's it for the DC and AC power sources.